Okay, guys, because I'm not really feeling up to doing much else, let's do this, because it is kind of interesting. Maybe some of you have heard of it, you just didn't really understand what it was about. So let's talk about this for a little bit. I'll tell you right now, just to ruin it, it is a load of crap, just like most things of this kind, myth or whatever you want to call it. There's things that you can do to prove that it's either is or it isn't, and in this case, it isn't. It's just a coincidence, and many of these that are usually associated with the third console, as you can see by the title, this is about third console curse. It's usually a load of crap because the ones they give, either they say it before the thing's even out, in the case like just say this list here I made so I don't get off track. They say the Xbox One. Now say whatever you want about it, the thing's not out. You don't know how it's gonna do. Yeah, it had a huge backlash and all that kind of stuff, but it's not out yet. You don't know what it's gonna do. And then there's also cases of these ones where they say it did horrible when in reality it really didn't. It just didn't do that good, or they turn it around later on. In the case of a couple, I'll go through. So I'm just going to mention some of the usual suspects, as it is, for the ones that they say suffer from the third console curse. But before I do, I'll give you a quick example of what, or I'll explain to you what this supposedly is. And I'm quoting here from someone who said this. This is probably the best way I've seen it worded without making it really long. The third console curse roughly states that you will stumble, not necessarily fail. See, doesn't necessarily mean the thing will fail itself with the third console you release. So here's some of the ones that they list, and I'm actually gonna go through a few of these and explain why it makes no sense. And this is just a myth that cropped up a long time ago because someone was bored and was looking at this stuff. But anyway, so usually they say the PlayStation 3. Right away, you should be able to figure out why that's not true. They turned it around later on, but I'll get back to that. Next, for Microsoft, we have the Xbox One again, or the X1, as I say it. Again, not things not out. You don't know how it's going to do. The Virtual Boy, which is actually a, technically they call it a handheld, it's not really a console, but whatever. Then again, they have the 3DS. Again, they turned that around, as you know, or might know. The N64, the Wii U, yet again, the thing hasn't been out that long, so you have no idea what it's going to do. And then down here, we have Sega with a Master System. Again, not true if you actually bother to look into it, because it did well in Europe and Japan. It didn't do well in North America, so that doesn't make it a failure. And the Dreamcast, which the thing was doing very well, has many fans to this day. It just was killed off by the PlayStation 2 and a couple other things, namely Sega's money troubles that stemmed from back from the 32X, the Neptune, which never came out, and the Sega Saturn. So there you go. So just looking at this here overall in general, let's go back and talk about one or two of these just as a good example of why this makes no sense. First off, the PlayStation 3. It had a rough start going. They charged too much money for it. A lot of people got put off by that, so on and so forth. The Xbox 360 had a lead, had a lot more install base, and so on and so forth, even though it had its own problems. We know that. Look at it now. PlayStation 3 started turning around at about mid to late 2008 and 2009, and right now it's doing extremely well. So there you go. The thing turned itself around. Just because it's not an instant success like the first PlayStation does not make it a bad console, doesn't make it the third console that's bad or anything like that, and it doesn't make it a failure, you know? And let's use another one, the X1. That thing's not out yet. No one, other than the people who are using the, what do they call them? Like the beta test versions or whatever it is, like that one moron who broke his NDA and put videos up on YouTube, and that's why they got taken down, because he broke his non-disclosure agreement. But stuff like that, those are the only ones actually using stuff like that. The Virtual Boy, that was just a bad idea in general because they didn't really market it correctly. They said it was virtual reality when they should have said it was 3D, a precursor to 3DS, which is obvious when you look at the 3DS. They definitely were thinking back to the Virtual Boy, and unlike back then, now they can actually achieve that kind of technology and make it work without needing any goofy ass goggles or anything like that. But even then, themselves, they're moving away from it. In fact, there was a video the other day I saw, Review Tech USA, Rich, he was talking about that and how, or no, it was TB in his content patch. One of the things he was talking about, he says it's interesting, he finds that they're moving away from it. You see, it's not really a failure, they just changed in the way it is, you know, with the 2DS. And the 3DS, remember, since that's the next one that's usually said here, they turned that around. Yes, it was doing bad for quite a long time, but they turned it around. Right now, it is the top-selling dedicated handheld gaming system. It's outselling the Vita, sorry. And, you know, there you go there. You know, N64, true, it didn't do that well compared to the PlayStation. It did better than the Saturn. And, you know, it wasn't really that much of a failure. People still like it to this day, or at least games on it. And it's a lot of people had it. I don't see how it's a failure. It didn't do as well as its competition, one in particular, again, the PlayStation, but that doesn't make it a failure. It makes no sense. This is the one I love the best, because this one is the newest one, literally, to this whole entire thing that they usually add with the third console thing. I find it funny how they go GameCube, Wii, and then Wii U, because a lot of people consider the GameCube to be a failure, even though it really wasn't. It didn't do that well, but it wasn't a failure. They actually made money off of it. Nintendo, I mean, the company that made it. Now, here's what I find about the Wii U, and it's kind of hilarious, annoying, and stupid at the same time. The thing hasn't been out long enough. You don't know how it's going to do. They just did a price cut, literally, it went into effect the day before today. Today's the 21st, I figured it went into effect yesterday, the 20th. It's now $2.99, and they only make the black deluxe one now. And they also have that bundle of the Zelda one, which I'd like to see if I can get. But it's not out long enough to even make any kind of call of that. Even the Saturn, as bad as it ended up doing, you couldn't tell how it was going to do when it was out for this long. The Wii U has not been out literally for an entire year yet. So how can you claim that kind of stuff? That's why this whole third console curse thing makes no damn sense. And let's, you know what, I might as well, since I ended up going for them, let's go for the last two. The Master System. As I said, you can look this up yourself, it didn't do well in North America at all. Because many reasons. Marketing, it was competition against the NES, which that was it wasn't likely it was going to beat that out. Even if it was more powerful hardware-wise and so on and so forth, it just didn't have what the NES had. Also, the NES had about a year head start, not counting just in Japan, too. So, it didn't do well in North America, but it did really good in Japan and PAL territories. It's true. The Dreamcast, as I already said, I'm pretty sure many of you know this because you probably have one, you like it a lot. Even if you don't have one still right now, but whatever, I have a broken one on the floor. The thing has a lot of fans. A lot of people liked it back when it came out and was still being made and supported, and a lot of people still like it now. Enough that they're actually still making homebrew games for it and releasing them, like Gunlord. Just because the thing stopped being made very soon doesn't make it bad. I said before, and a lot of people know this because they're not naive, you go back and you look, it's Sega's past problems catching up to them with the Dreamcast. Also, when the PlayStation 2 came out, that basically put the final nail in the coffin for it. It wasn't the Dreamcast's fault, it wasn't Sega's fault. It wasn't able to compete against the PlayStation 2, and their money problems that stem from the past came up to them. That's why. It has nothing to do with no third console coming out as the curse. So then the other question becomes, and this is the one I usually ask, how do you explain it then if you go back further in these games' history's company, how do you explain that the third console didn't really do that bad? You say, or yeah, how about ones that don't have three consoles? How do you explain that one? Oh, here's one better. How do you explain that the Atari 7800, which technically if you skip a few like revisions, you have the 2600, the 5200, and then you had the 7800. How do you explain that the 7800, technically the third console if you were to go buy it that way, sold better and was a better built thing in general than the 5200? That's the third one, and it did better than the second one. You see, there's things like that there. This whole third console curse thing is nothing more than a myth, and it's a load of crap in itself. There's really nothing to it that actually gives it any kind of credence. It's just some kind of hip thing, fad to say, is like the third console did really bad, but as I explained it throughout this thing, they really didn't. It's a load of crap. Some did really bad, yeah they did, but it's got nothing to do with them being the third console. So that means, say, if a company just came out now, it means the first and second one do really good, that means automatically, because of this, the third one's going to do bad? No. It means nothing like that. It's either got to do with competition, it's got to do with the company didn't market it right, or the thing itself doesn't have the games there, or the thing itself is bad. That's what it is. It's got nothing to do with no third console thing. Alright? It's really funny to say otherwise. I mean, technically, every system that Atari made after the first one, just using this example again, was bad. So that's a second, third, fourth, fifth, and fifth console curse, apparently, for them. Only their 2600 really was the most successful, counting consoles. Yes, I know about their computers, but I'm not talking about that. So, what would you say to that? It can't be positive. This whole third console curse thing is hilarious in itself. I always thought it was nothing more than anything just that people came up with for being bored and thought it was hilarious. Because, yes, it is. There is something to it there that you can say that the third console for many of these, although, by the way, the Wii U is not the third console Nintendo made. There's another reason I don't believe any of this shit, because it makes no sense. It's not their third console. The N64 is their third console. But anyway, it's It's stupid. It makes no sense. If you actually look at it, think about it, it makes no sense. There's nothing to it. This whole third console curse thing, it never made any sense back when I first heard it, and it makes no sense now. Especially when you actually think about it. You actually look into it, and you actually look back at these so-called third failures and look at their actual, the way they turned out. Both their sales and all the other stuff combined. It really makes no sense. They did bad, as I said, were not as well as some of the other ones in their competition, but it doesn't make them a failure. Even as I said in the what the supposed explanation of what the third console curse is, even says in there, not always a failure. But apparently, to some people, they think that means that the third console, that automatically means that's why it's not doing good, like the X1, the Wii U, and so on and so forth. The best example, probably, of this whole thing was the PlayStation 3, even though it was the first one I mentioned, because they turned that around tremendously. Yeah, they messed up with it, but they fixed it later on. They rectified the mistakes they made, and they made a real hot seller, basically. A lot of people like the stuff on it, the games on it, and it all comes down to the games. So, there you go. That's all there is to say about it. So that's it for this kind of mini VGR thing here. I tried to not get so energetic in this, because it kind of aggravates the condition, but oh well. So yeah, if, you know, and one thing I do want to say, if you made it to this point actually, otherwise you wouldn't hear it, is if you do believe in this third console curse, I'm fine with that. I'm just giving basically evidence that it makes no sense. That's all I'm doing here, and I'm talking about me personally. I think it's a load of malarkey, you know. If you think it is, it's fine. I have nothing against that. I have no problems with it if you think it's real. I have no problems with that at all. I don't care. It's fine. You can, just like I can think it doesn't exist, you know. So don't think I'm talking about you personally, because most of the likely, I have no idea who you are. So there's no way I could be talking about you, not to mention anyone in particular. This is something that many, many, many over time have said and mentioned think is a real thing. It rarely comes up anymore, by the way, which is kind of the reason I'm talking about it. I find it odd that of all the channels I'm subscribed to, which a lot of them aren't even about video games, but whatever, the ones that are, I've actually, even if I haven't been watching them since their start, I've actually looked back in their video things and searched. I really don't find any have done any videos, even if it's something like this, just talking about this so-called third console curse. I find that weird. You figure they would, because they talk about this, all this other dumb crap, like Luigi being in Super Mario 64 and stuff like that. But, you know, it really makes no sense. It just doesn't, when you think about it. I'm that kind of person. I'm one of those logical, technical thinking kind, and unless I see proof that it, you know, something like that is possible, it just makes no sense. Then if you think about it, so that means it's impossible for the fourth or even the second console to be a failure or have that kind of thing happen to it. Remember what I said about Atari? Pretty much everything they had after the 2600 was not doing good. In fact, they progressively got worse in some cases. So, you know, just using that one thing, what do you got to say about that? You know, how about the PSP? The second one in its line, the Go, was the one that did the worst. PSP did really good. The Vita, by comparison to the Go, is doing really good compared to that. But that's the second one in that line. That one did bad. So, yeah, what do you got for that one? And some, by the way, stretch this further and actually call it the fourth console curse. So, even then, that shows that even they don't believe the whole third thing. As they say, oh, that goes to the fourth one. Even then, if they stretch it to four, it sometimes doesn't count. Again, let's use Nintendo. Their fourth console was not the Wii U or any of the ones that you like picking on. Fourth one was the GameCube, which I said didn't do that well compared to its competition, but it didn't do that bad when you look at it on its own. So, you gotta think about these things sometimes. You just gotta look at it. You can't take it at what some people call face value. You actually sometimes do have to look into it, and then when you do, you find that some of the stuff makes no sense. It's a little thing you gotta do with any of these kind of myths and stuff like this. Just because it's very widespread and a lot of people like to talk about it and think it's real doesn't always make it true. It's like that whole crap about alligators being in the sewer. Either you can believe it or you can actually think about, like, does this make sense? That's all I'm saying. That's all I ask anytime someone does this kind of stuff is, like, at least think about it in the way that is this even remotely make sense in any way? That's what I'm saying. It just is kind of one of those things, like, oh, it just so happens that the third console that pretty much all these companies made just did shit, when the ones before it and after it probably did good. That's what it comes down to. It. That's what this whole thing is. And it's just, it's lame. It's not really a good explanation for what happened to them. It's not a good explanation for why they turned out the way they did, why they didn't sell well, or so on and so forth. It just doesn't. And as you heard me minutes ago, I gave evidence that you can look up for all those systems why they didn't do good. I gave reasons for them. And it's not my own personal reasons, it's well-known reasons, and that's why they didn't work. Like the Virtual Boy, there's well-known reasons why that didn't work. So, you know, and the PlayStation 3, bringing that up one more time, they turned that around. They turned the 3DS around. They're in the process right now of turning the Wii U around. And again, with that one, it's not out long enough for you to even say if it's going to do bad or not. You don't know. Especially considering that the other two in the 8th generation aren't even out yet. And going back to that one, the X1, you can't say anything about that other than what you don't like it's going to have or not, but you can't say if it's going to turn out bad or not. You don't know that. There's going to be people that are going to buy the thing, without a doubt. So, you don't know how it's going to do. Will it do as good as the Xbox 360? Who knows? Maybe, maybe not. Might do better, might do worse. You don't know. You can't say until something like that comes out. So, that's another thing that that's probably the thing I find the most annoying about this whole third console curse, by the way. One last thing I want to say about it is that a lot of times it's usually ones that aren't even out yet that you cannot even literally buy and get your hands on and use that they add to this list of third console curse victims, so to speak. How can you say that? You can't use the thing, you've never used the thing, you don't know anything about it, and let alone, not just because you can't use it, no one else can buy it, so you don't even know if it's going to sell good or how good it's going to turn out that way. So it's impossible. You can guess, but you gotta say you're guessing. You can't say for a fact it's gonna be bad. You can't do that. It's not good. But anyway, so that's it. So thanks for watching and listening. There's not really gonna be anything to watch. It's just gonna be a picture. But whatever. So anymore lately, I'm doing VGR by myself. But you know what? That's fine. It's how I started the first one. And I'm actually gonna do something different here if you made it to this point, which I hope you did, because, you know, it's not really that long compared to some of the other VGRs I've done. If you have a topic that you could suggest for me to do for this, go ahead. So it doesn't always have to be old, although I do like doing those a lot, preferably over the current stuff, but if you want me to do something current that I haven't already done, of course, you know, suggest it to me and I'll do it. Of course, if it's doable, you know. So, that's about it. I will see you later.